Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to talk to you guys about a breastfeeding issue that I have gone through. Anyway, I'm going to tell you kind of just what has happened in the past week. And, well, really happened the past week, but previous months before this whole thing started. I decided to do a whole video on this because I feel like if there's another mom out there who is breastfeeding their baby, who are having similar symptoms as I had, and don't have a clue what's wrong, I hope this video helps you. Because I went months undergoing pain that I did not need to deal with if I just would have known. So that's what this video is going to be about. So if you are a nursing mother and you are interested in finding out what I am talking about, please keep watching. Let me give you a background story about our breastfeeding journey first. Breeland latched on right away. She has always been an excellent nurser. She is not one to nurse for comfort, and she is not one to nurse just because. She nurses when she's hungry, and when she's done, she's done. She's like 8 minutes on the breast and she's done. Like, I got my fill, I'm done with this. I don't want any more. I don't want to just hang around. She's done. So she has always been aggressive though, very aggressive nurser. One that tugs and pulls and just does all, I mean, just crazy stuff, right? Well, none of my other two have ever been this aggressive. And I'm like, this is really weird that she's doing this. And she started being really aggressive about 4 weeks when she was about a month old. She was really, really, really aggressive and has been ever since. Well, when she was about 2 months old, I started noticing white stuff in her mouth. And I noticed that my chest was very like red and shiny and just burning every time she ate. My immediate thought was thrush. We have thrush. And I had thrush in my other two, so I already knew what it looked like and what it was. So I went ahead and emailed the doctor, got medicine for it, and we treated each other. I treated each one of us for, you know, the amount of time that it said. And it got better. Well, I started noticing that I was getting lacerations where the nipple meets the areola. Is that what that's called? Anyway, where the two meet, I was getting lacerations there and they hurt so bad. I couldn't touch them. I couldn't, it was just really, really excruciatingly painful to nurse. And so then I end up having my emergency surgery. And so I got to where I was pumping part-time and nursing part-time to get through the surgery. And when I did that, I healed. Well, then a week after, when she was nursing full-time for another week, the lacerations came back, I mean, with a vengeance. They were so bad, you guys. I had my left side starting from the very, very top and went all the way around to the bottom. And it literally, guys, this video is totally TMI, but it literally felt and looked like she was going to pull my nipple off. And so you could just imagine how painful it was. The right side was painful too, but not as bad. Now, I was done. I could not nurse her on the left side. It hurt way too bad. So I didn't know what else to do but to call a lactation consultant. So I called the LC and I actually talked to several of them and they kept telling me, Julie, these are symptoms of a lip tie. And I'm like, a lip tie? I don't even know what a lip tie is. I know what a tongue tie is, but not a lip tie. Well, so what she wanted me to do was lay her on the changing table and lift her top lip up to her nostril, basically, and look to see where that flap of skin in there is connected to her gums. Well, if it's a normal, if it's normal the way it's supposed to be connected, then it's like way up here, right? Well, Breland's was like right here, the top of where her teeth come in, considered a lip tie. And because of that, she couldn't get her lip to do what it was supposed to do, and so it causes these lacerations on the nipple. And they will not go away until the issue is fixed. So I was so happy to know that. It made so much sense. If you guys have watched any of my previous vlogs, you've seen Breland do her tongue thing. That's why. That's why she does the tongue thing, because she had a lip tie. And that's why she wouldn't take a pacifier. It makes so much sense now. Ugh, I'm so frustrated because the doctor was supposed to check that at 2 weeks and they didn't check it. So I suffered through all this pain and I didn't need to. Anyway, that's my soapbox, but that's beside the point. So I got an appointment immediately in to see a dentist for them to clip her lip tie. So they clipped it yesterday. And it was nothing, you guys. She didn't even cry a hurtful cry. She had no pain at all. They numbed it, they clipped it, they picked her up on the table, and she was smiling this really funky smile because she was numb. It was really cute. But anyway, it was fine. It was painless. Like, she didn't even care. She took a bottle right afterwards, drank 4 ounces, and was great, you guys. So, but don't some doctors like will do some laser treatment or put your baby to sleep? Oh my goodness, don't let them do that. Find a dentist that uses sterile scissors and a topical numbing ointment. That's all you need. Seriously, don't let people charge you an arm and a leg. But you want to know the coolest part about all of this? When we called to make the appointment, they told me it was going to be $205. And I was like, fine, I don't care. Let's just get her in and get it done. We'll pay for it. You guys, when we got there and they did the procedure, the dentist said, you know what? He didn't charge us. No cost today. I'm like, are there seriously dentists out there that can just decide if they want to charge you or not? Because this one did. And I'm like, are you kidding me? What an answered prayer. Like, this was $200 out of our pocket, and we don't even have to pay for it. Because he was so sweet and generous and decided that that day he was going to let us not pay for it. I couldn't believe it, you guys. But anyway, so I will have to do an update to this video, but I wanted to put this out there in case any of you all have these symptoms and you're going through this. Check the lip. Check the lip. If you don't know what a lip tie is, Google image it and you will see what I mean. All it is when that piece of skin has connected your lip to right here. And sometimes, if they already have teeth in, it'll go in between their two front teeth. And then, a lot of times, if you haven't caught it and you're not nursing, and they fall, they could just tear it and then it's gone, obviously. But it'll bleed a lot when they do that. But anyway, so we got it clipped. I can't wait to try to nurse her again. I am pumping and bottle feeding right now so I can heal. And then I will put her back on. I am hoping by Monday she'll get to nurse. So I'm hoping. I'll probably try it on Monday and see how she does. But I just want to heal so she doesn't open those wounds back up. So anyway, that is that. If you have any questions at all, please comment down below. You can message me. I check them, and respond. So feel free to please contact me if you have any nursing questions whatsoever. I've nursed 3 babies. I've had who knows what happen with who knows which kid. So seriously, if you've got questions, please ask them. I'm happy to answer them. And I really, really hope this video helps some of you out there. And I just couldn't let this pass without doing a video on it because I was completely clueless. And the cure was so simple. I just wish I would have known at her 2 week checkup that she had a lip tie. So check your baby's lips if you're having issues, you guys. And thumbs up this video. Thumbs up this video if you liked it. And don't forget to subscribe. And I love you guys, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye!